E4D Talk Show, which promises to share stories of many inspiring speakers on board. I am Shavinder Kaur, and I am the host of this ICK-initiated, wonderful, power-packed global talk show series. Indian Navy veteran and astute military professional with magnificent hands-on experience of over 16 years in leading multi-diverse teams as a school captain and as an officer in the Indian Navy. Please welcome our guest for today's show, Commander Prabha Lal.
Thank you.
Welcome to the show.
Thank you, ma'am.
Before we start the conversation, I want our listeners to know her achievement and her endeavors. She has vast experience in the field of education, training, administration, and management. She is BTech qualified and she holds an MBA in human resources. She has done PSO course from the Defense Institute of Psychological Research. She has rich experience of administration of the reputed Navy children schools. She has diverse experience in managing people and focusing on their innate capabilities and further streamlining the potential for various tasks with high morale. She was also commended twice by the Flag Officer Commanding in Chief for her dedication to service. She is now a motivational speaker, a life coach with a mission to help people change their life by improving one's social skills, happiness, productivity, and awesomeness. That's a wonderful bio and truly inspiring while I was reading, you know. So, Commander Prabha Lal, we all of us are nowadays talking about skills and upskilling and honing our skills. So, what according to you is the most important skill in the present scenario?
We live in a world which is constantly changing. If you see the present situation also. So this world is typically characterized by VUCA, which we call is, this is a term which has been coined late in the 1980s by the Marine Commandos. Now this VUCA stands for V for volatile, U for uncertain, C for complex, and A for ambiguous. If you see, this four things fit into today's world. So we need to counter, this is the question and the answer also lies there. So we need to counter volatility with our vision, uncertainty with our understanding, and complexity with clarity, and the most important, ambiguous with agility and adaptability. So if you ask me, the most important skill today is adaptability. Lyndon also says that adaptability is one of the top skills in terms of any organization, among the top 4%. So you see, in today's world, change or otherwise also, change is the only thing which is constant, keeps on changing. The scenario changes, the situation changes, the place remains same, the person remains same, but the time is different. So PPT, everything changes. One variable changes. So what happens, as Charles Darwin has also mentioned, that it is not the survival of the fittest or the most intelligent person. The person who will survive is the person who is the most adaptable. So I feel that it is now time to up your AQ. You must have heard about IQ, EQ. Now there is a new term, AQ, adaptability quotient. The more adaptable you are, the more you can gel well in your organization or in your life. You can get inside any situation. No, you can do anything if you are adaptable. Learn new things. Learn, unlearn, and relearn. That is the mantra. So I would say adaptability is the name of the new game.
So true. And the VUCA term is, you know, very often used in the military, and absolutely important for all of us to adapt to the situation. That's what the new NEP also, I'm glad it talks about, you know, teaching children of life skills from the formative years. Being an educationist, I have personally realized how important it is for children from the formative years to understand the importance of life skills. Continuing with the same discussion, how do you, according to you, know, a goal setting is important in the turbulent times, you know?
Definitely, it is one of the most important thing, be it turbulent times or otherwise also. But in turbulent times, so as we are know, we must have prepared our long-term goals. It is all dhara ka dhara. So you should, as I mentioned, it is all volatile. So you should have that vision in your mind, set your long-term goals, but move towards it with short-term goals. With this short-term goals, should be flexible enough. You should keep on refining it. It should be just like the way you have this control system wherein in a car, you're driving and you're pressing the accelerator. As and when required, you press it, depending on your requirement and the situation which is in front of you on the road. You will not push the throttle because you will assess the situation. So goal setting in the present times, it should be short term, definitely. It should be broken down into achievable, quantifiable things, realistic also. So I would suggest it should be done and revised maybe in a week. Now we can't, in the present time, we can't make plans for a year. We have to now focus on a week and then move ahead, because let's say we are right now in lockdown. I cannot plan something. So depending on the situation, we have to move forward.
Beautiful example that you gave about the lockdown, and all of us are kind of sailing in the same boat, you know. And but there is so much that we have learned in our lockdown, you know, so much that we can do. And of course, the goals got to be very much achievable. You can't set goals which are not achievable. Then the meaning of goal setting will differ. You know, another one big issue that people face, the youth, that they generally face, is the procrastination. So how do you think that we should be able to deal with it?
See, procrastination is something which is within us. It's our inner voice which is creating the problem. You know, just like in mobile, in our smartphones, we have this very beautiful button called snooze button. We want to get up in the morning, we set an alarm, but then with technology, there is also an added disadvantage. It's very nicely swipe that snooze button. So this is that inner voice which tells us not to take that action. So procrastination is basically overcoming that inner voice and take action. It's a very nice technique which has been coined by Mel Robbins. She says that there's a 5-second rule. The moment you have a thought in your mind and you want to take action, do not let the inner voice take over it. Start 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Get up. In the morning, when you just open your eyes, you have to wake up. Don't let that thing settle down. Just go for it. At least start the work. Once you have started the work, you know, you will be able to achieve 20% there and there. And there is one more saying that you should eat that frog. Now, this is a different term.
Yes. Yes.
Eat that frog. Now, what is this? Eat that frog. Do the most difficult task first thing. You will realize that if the task is only 20% in quantity, but once you finish it, you will be able to finish 80% of your job, because the balance 80% is only tits and bits, and you will feel a different sense of satisfaction once you complete that task. So this way you can overcome and focus on your strengths. Do it, quickly do it. You'll definitely do it.
Incredible examples that you've shared, you know, most importantly, it is the time management that is required. You're being focused, and go get her attitude. So that's a very nicely and aptly that you have explained. Moving on with the same kind of conversation. People often don't like fear or failure or self-doubt. Most of the time we have the self-doubt whether I'll be able to do it or not. So, you being into the, coaching and training. So how do you train your people or your, trainees to handle this?
See, fear or failure. So there's something in our brain, which amygdala, which we call, which has this fear, fight or flight. Generally, yes. It is the normal tendency. 80% of the people will feel, bhag jao. Because the brain, if you see, the reptilian part of the brain is only made to survive. Comfort. It doesn't let you go out of your comfort zone. So, again, you'll have to kick yourself. I'm also learning. As I told you, like today, I'm in my second innings. And the world is totally new. I am learning daily. So this fear, log kya kahenge? If I keep on thinking about this, log kya kahenge? Today I would not have been sitting here. So this, okay, if I do something, I'll fail. So what? At least I have tried. Till the time I don't taste a particular dish, how will I come to know how does it taste? Let me try it. I might fail. So what is more important is, failing is okay, falling down is also okay, but more important than that is, you need to get up, bounce back.
Try it, try to fall down, try to then get up.
Yes.
So it's, of course, it's a, if you want to pursue it like that, you will, otherwise you will keep sitting with your self-doubts. Interesting to know that aspect also. You were from the forces, and once a soldier, always a soldier. The armed forces personnels are resilient. Do you think it's the fact?
Yes, I would 100% vouch for it, because we are trained in such a way that the physical conditions or the training environment, it makes you learn. They train you in that environment. Because it is said, the more you sweat in peace, the less you bleed in war. So what are we doing right now?
Wherever I work, I always say this, it's very important.
So we have to train ourselves for the future. What are we doing? There is no war going on right now. But we are training ourselves through exercises, through any calamity. That is also part of our training, right? So we people are trained, and we are not going to say that, okay, we do not have this resources or whatever we have, we have. Geeta also says, jo hai so hai, embrace the reality. Whatever is the resources given to you, you have to move forward. Tomorrow you cannot back out. So we are trained to be resilient, and that is part of our nature right now.
True. And half of the time we always have that feeling ki ab kare, kal kare, kab kare, but I always feel, start from where you are, do whatever from what you have, and then launch yourself, that's how it is. And I'm glad that I'm hosting Fauji here. So my viewers would like to also know, those young generation, any tips or a few things that you could tell defense aspirants for SSB?
For SSB, okay. See, in SSB, you have to be truthful. Integrity is one part, which is one of the core values of any defense forces. Now there you cannot have a mismatch. Mismatch means you can learn from, like in the present situation, you will have n number of things available on the internet. Don't try to copy everything. Be your true self. There are various, some people will say try to be positive or be helping in nature in whatever you write or whatever. But the SSBs are meant in such a way that they will find out. Let's say there is a story writing and you write, I saw a lady in the water or in the river and I jumped. But in some of the physical activity, you are hesitant to even take a small leap. So 2 + 2 = 4. Somewhere or the other, it will be reflected. Try to be a better version of yourself, not somebody else's. You can't copy somebody. Improve on your own skills. Observe rather than see. You need to observe what is given around. As I mentioned, look what is around. Find your team's strengths and weaknesses. Those strengths can be used somewhere. Let's say somebody is fat in a group task. He can give you advantage for a weight. If somebody is tall, observe what is there in your team. Who are your team members? Because at the end of the day, you have to take the team along with you. You cannot leave your buddy in between. Even if he is injured in the war, we don't leave them. We take them along. So remember that thing. Teamwork is very important. Okay. So don't try to copy. Don't try and be a copycat. Observe. And like, there are many activities. Simple signs. You daily open, use a stapler, or you take and open a can. So what is that? These are what? Simple machines? First order, second order. You must have heard lever, fulcrum, load, effort. Observe. And find a solution in whatever you have. So, yes. Have that confidence. Believe in yourself. You will be able to do it. Why not?
Yes. This is very nice that you just stated, you know, teamwork. I always feel that, you know, no matter who scores the goal, it's the entire team which wins it. And taking care of your buddies, your, you know, brother officers or Jawan, that's what we learned so much. It's ingrained in all of us, you know. I am from the 4G background. Everybody, we keep hearing the story. So it's ingrained, you know, that's definitely very important for all of us. So this is a very important tip that you gave, to be honest, to be true to yourself. And that's where you are able to exhibit and you will be able to prove it in the SSB. All the very best to all those who are preparing for SSB, you know, this year in this lockdown, especially. Great. Thank you so much, Commander Lal. And when I read about your bio that you are a coach, you're a life coach. So I want to know the 3 important tips that you would give to your listeners, that how can we live a life better and happy?
See, first and foremost thing, you should be first ready to accept the situation. I always tell everybody that this happiness comes from within. First. Second is, if you give, you will receive. That is a universal truth. Just like an Instagram. The more you like somebody, the more likes you will receive. You know, that way. Third point. You should be humble towards the society, and always be ready to learn something new. So whenever you are learning something, you appreciate things better. Your attitude towards the people, towards the surrounding will change. So these are the 3 things which I tell people, always keep in mind.
That's incredible, Commander Lal, and this is definitely a very enriching episode. I myself has learned so much from your inspiring value addition. Thank you once again for being a part of this interesting women's special series, Choose to Challenge. She makes the day brighter. She leaves a little sparkle wherever she goes. That's our guest today, Commander Prabha Lal. Thank you once again. I thank all our viewers. Please like, share and subscribe to our channel, E4G Talk Show. And don't forget to put in your review in the comment section. For more interesting stories, please stay tuned. Till then, stay home, stay safe. Jai Hind.
Body Talks is brought to you by ISECI, Indian Ex-Defence Service Employees Chamber of Commerce and Industries. Thanks to its vast veteran network and global and pan-India associates, ISECI can carry out various commerce facilitations and CSR projects across India and the world. Some of ISECI's core capability areas are Skill India, Atmanirbhar Bharat, Digital India, any ex-serviceman welfare or job program, Swachh Bharat Abhiyan related projects, telemedicine and healthcare training and job scheme, Save Water scheme, defense industry SME, MSME cluster and hub development, maritime training and inland water training with job facilitation, Canada study, job and permanent residency opportunity, e-commerce, Andaman and Nicobar commerce opportunities. ISECI's global reach includes countries like Indonesia, Slovakia, Canada, Nepal, Singapore, Rwanda, USA, UK. Above all, it is ISECI's effort to create a veterans brand made by the veterans, for the veterans and made up of the veterans. Every Indian's support is invaluable in this journey. ISECI is a registered society for ex-servicemen's welfare and envisions that every veteran should be a part of India's economic growth story. It is the aim of ISECI to create an enabling commerce platform that will empower and synergize the veterans' talent pool. This is possible only with the support of entrepreneurs, businesses and consultants from civil society. All proceeds, if any, are utilized for the welfare of ex-servicemen and for public charity.